Let's take a look at the structure of the galaxy. This is the galaxy seen from the outside, from above. Obviously, it is not a photograph because no object ever thrown by human beings has gone so far, so simply a graphic representation, a drawing. Let's start with the main element, which is the core. Inside the core there is a supermassive black hole, that is, a black hole with a mass equivalent to millions of times that of stellar black holes. So we're going to look at black holes in the fourth lesson of my course, and I'm going to talk extensively about supermassive black holes and their differences with normal stellar black holes. Then there's the solar system. We are here, in this arm, which is called the arm of Orion. In fact, this arm takes its name from the constellation of Orion, which is located more or less 1,500 light years from us. This is the constellation as it appears on the star map. This is in the photograph. You see the star Betelgeuse, which is a red supergiant that's about to explode, and the other younger stars, because from their color we understand that they're very hot, and very hot stars live very little, so they can't be very old. Then again we have the Sagittarius arm, that is, between the Orion arm and the galactic nucleus, there is an arm of stardust, which is the galactic arm. We'll see that these arms are actually density waves. The Orion arm, which is the one we are in, is a branch of the Sagittarius arm, so in fact this arm is not directly connected with the nucleus as the Sagittarius arm, but it is between the Sagittarius arm and the Perseus arm, so we are in an intermediate arm. As you can see, if we look into the interior of the galaxy, we see the Via Lactea. In fact, the constellation of Sagittarius, which gives its name to the arm, we see it right in the direction of the galactic nucleus, while the constellation of Perseus, which gives its name to the Perseus arm, we see it on the opposite side of the Via Lactea, therefore in the least bright area of the sky. Then we have the outer arm, which we can't see well from Earth because in the middle is the arm of Perseus. And then the Swan arm, which would be the opposite arm of the galaxy with respect to the Sagittarius arm. Then there is a second outer arm, which is the arm of the Cross Shield. This is the main structure of the Via Lactea, but one thing that must be said is that we cannot see this part beyond the nucleus, because the nucleus obscures us, so there is an area of the galaxy that we cannot see and that. We imagine it could be so, because we see the other galaxies similar to ours, and therefore seeing the other galaxies, and seeing how ours develops, scientists have reconstructed the missing part. This is just an excerpt from my video lesson on the Via Lactea in the full lesson. I'm talking about the galactic arms, what they are and how they formed, the plasma jets of active galaxies, and the deformation of the galactic plane of the Via Lactea, and how this can be represented as a giant tidal wave produced by nearby galaxies. More, I'll talk about galactic impacts and what awaits the Via Lactea with the Andromeda galaxy. And then, of course, I'm going to talk about the galactic core and a gigantic supermassive black hole that hides inside it. You can find all my complete video lesson on Via Lactea and the complete course of Astromia on my YouTube channel, Professor Antonio Loiacono. Thank you.